Welcome to my new senior year apartment. Come on in. So when you enter into my living room, the first thing you can see is a mirror. And this is really crucial for when we take pictures. This is actually the same mirror that we had from our last apartment and we just brought it over here. And then when you pan over, you can see this is the general entry area for our living room. And so a brief little tour of the overall concept of our living room. We made it a kind of gray, green, gold theme. So here we have a gray futon, which we got from Wayfair, and it actually folds back, but the problem with this futon is that, story time, we had guests over, and someone was sitting here, and I leapt on top of that person, and then our futon collapsed. So this crappy $200 futon that I got from Wayfair is clearly not sustainable, but it's good for college living because it's lasted us for the past 1.5 years, and after this semester is over, we're pretty much just gonna get rid of it. And these pillows, we just got them from TJ Maxx or Home Goods, I believe, so all really on a budget. And this throw is from Target. Panning over here, we have our lovely coffee table. And this coffee table is also from Wayfair. We got a couple little decorations here because we want it to be very spring and pretty. And these are from Home Goods and Target. And then over here, we have a nice kind of structural geometric lamp, which we got from Walmart. And it was a really good deal. It was under $100, best thing ever. And then over here, we have a nice little accent chair. This is also from Wayfair, top with a green pillow. I believe this is from Home Goods. Most of the things that we got were really from Home Goods and Target and Walmart. And we did a lot of DIY art. So here on this wall, we have 3 abstract art pieces. I'll let you guys comment down below which one you think I did, which one you think Case did, and which one you think Annie did, because each one of these art pieces was done by each housemate, and they're very abstract, as you can tell, and they all follow the same theme of green, gold, silver, gray. So I think that this is a really nice touch because it makes the apartment a little bit more homey, a little bit more unique, and I just think it's really cool that we were able to decorate our apartment with our own style. Over here, we have our Christmas tree. So for our Christmas tree, it's been here for a while. I know it's March. Listen, Christmas does not end in this household. It is always Christmas. And honestly, the reason why we have this Christmas tree is because it gives the best ambiance. It sets the mood. It's lovely. Like, it's not like we study here in the living room anyway. It's for the nice mood. And we have all of these little champagne little baubles on here. And if you guys zoom in closely, Case and I, we actually decorated some of our own unique little ornaments. So we have our own little personal touch to this. She made
broccoli.
She made broccoli. This is an anime reference that I don't know anything about, but she made that. It's very cute, it's very intricate, as you can see the way she painted it. And oh, I made a golden snitch here because one of my all-time favorite movie series ever is Harry Potter, if you guys didn't know. And so I made this golden snitch. Everything else here, we just got it from Michael's and it was really, really inexpensive. This tree, I believe, used to be $130 and we got it for $40. And then we also just got the other ornaments. Across from the living area, we have our media stand slash dresser. So in here, we just kind of have all of our clothes. And so it's kind of functions doubly as both clothing storage and a media stand for our TV. This TV, we also brought it over from our last apartment and it is great. We watch Bachelor here, Bachelorette, we watch Disney movies. And so behind this TV, we have some fun card games because now that your girl's 21 and it's our senior year, we do have a few more get-togethers. We do a few more things. We play card games, we have like game nights. And so we bought some card games. We have Cards Against Humanity, classic favorite, everyone loves that. We have Never Have I Ever. And we also have 5-Second Rule. Oh, we have 5-Second Rule. Cards for whenever we play card games like Ride the Bus or whenever we're playing. And just some candles that we have here to set the mood. We really like mood in this apartment. Anything to make the apartment seem extra cozy. So moving on from the living room, which is just behind me, we are now in the dining and kitchen area. So as you can see right over here, we have a lovely bar cart. So this is also something that we bought recently in this year because everyone in our household is now 21. We have glasses, we have champagne flutes, we have different sort of coupes for martinis. We have wine glasses, and we even have these cute little shot glasses that Case got from Hawaii for us. And down here, we have an assortment of different alcohols, wine, spritz, like everything. And we have a whole bunch of different mixers. And I have recently, during quarantine, gotten really, really into bartending and just making drinks. I've always been a huge fan of making drinks. And so now that I drink alcohol, this is just a whole new realm for me to explore. And so that's why we have a ton of different kind of alcohol bottles here. And it's really for me to just play around and have fun. Moving in, this is the general kitchen area. And so this kitchen area is a huge upgrade from what we used to have before. The apartment that we had before, it was nice, but this is definitely a lot nicer. You can tell from the aesthetic, it is gray, there's some marble, the white cabinetry. It's just a lot prettier than what our old apartment used to be. And I'll put a link in the description box down below for our old apartment tour so you guys can check that out. So you can see how we've been slowly kind of upgrading our apartment as we've been getting older. In this counter, this is where I do all of my prep work. This is where I do all of my chopping, my cutting. And so we have some avocados here, just putting them out here to get it ripe. This is Case's plant that is completely dead, but she thinks that it has the ability to revive. So we just kind of keep it there and it makes her happy. So it's for the vibes, it's for the vibes. We love some greenery in this apartment. And these are some breads that I purchased the other day from Shanghi. I wanted to show you guys, this is something that I bought recently, or something Annie gifted me recently for Christmas. And this is a magnetic knife block. And so I'm able to put all of my knives here. And in the back, these are all spatulas for when I bake things. And so this has been really convenient, and it's a lot neater than having a whole knife block stand. Here we have a lovely, nice, large sink. And this is great for when we wash dishes, clean things. And then we have an ice maker. Annie has her Nespresso coffee maker. And then behind, we have a little itty bitty air fryer. And this is super handy because this is so freaking cute and small. And I believe it was only $20 on Macy's, so it was a great deal. And we use the air fryer for like heating things up. Case uses it for frying some tofu, and it's just really great. Moving on to this side, we have our stainless steel fridge. And since moving to this apartment, I've had a massive appreciation for stainless steel appliances because our previous apartments, we didn't have stainless steel. On the top over here, we have all of our different seltzers. I know this makes our apartment look like we're alcoholics, but I promise you we are not alcoholics. We just like to have a fully stocked kitchen. So here is our little canister where we put all of our different kitchen utensils. And over here we have our oil. Back here I actually have some chili oil that I made by hand, and I still need to consume that before it goes bad. Yeah, this is pretty much our entire kitchen. All of the cabinetries have other ingredients, but I'm not gonna go into detail with that because if I did, this video would actually be way too long. This is our dining table. And so this is the exact same dining table that we had before in our previous apartment, and we just brought this here. It fits perfectly into this little nook, and we just have our four chairs. And we also bought this clock from Target, and it's a nice, you know, aesthetic. I think it completes the wall, makes the wall look a little less boring. So now I'm gonna take you guys along into the bedrooms and the bathroom. Down here, right next to the media stand, I actually have some of my workout gear. So I try to do some home workouts every single day, and I just kind of keep all of my stuff down here. And right next to the whole living room is our bathroom. So this is our bathroom. This entire place is a two bed, one bathroom place actually. We have nice gray tiled bathtub, and we have a little plant shrubbery that we got here. We also have a matching green towels as well as a green bath mat. We just really wanted everything in our apartment to be as cohesive as possible. It was really important for us to keep the space really just clean and fresh. And behind the mirror is, it's a medicine cabinet. So we have all of our different skincare here. And I take up the most space. And I have pretty much this entire row and like half of the bottom too. Over here, right across from the bathroom, we have this closet door. It's really small. We kept a clothing hanger over here, so sometimes we can hang some of our jackets or hoodies and stuff. And this is more sort of just like a storage area. We have our different toiletries, our extra tissue paper and Kleenexes on the top. And this is a shoe rack for all the extra shoes. We have our Swiffer mop, some other miscellaneous things, our toolkit for when we need to fix things. It's really just a storage unit, essentially. But right next to that closet is our little pantry. Actually, I wouldn't even call this a pantry. This is kind of a pantry slash miscellaneous things because this apartment is quite small and we have a lot of things. So in general, like I would say the top four shelves are for food, and these are mostly dry ingredients. So we have like granola, oat milk, a bunch of like my tea stuff, snack things, and then we have candy, assortments of tuna, pasta, ramen, like I even have my protein shakes. And then down here we have like whitening strips, we have women's feminine products, and we have like our first aid kit, we have masks, and just like kind of like other random stuff down there. And now we can move in to one of the bedrooms in our two bed one bath apartment. As you can see, I live in a double. Casey's bed is over here and my bed is over there. And I know it does seem quite crowded, but Case and I, we wanted to live in a double because it's our last year together and we really just wanted to live out all of our years as a double together. So freshman year, we were in a double. Sophomore year, we were in a double. Junior year, we were in a triple. And now senior year, we're back in a double. We have matching nightstands, and these are still the same nightstands that we had from our previous apartment. Everything here is exactly the same as our previous apartment, essentially. We didn't get new bedding or new bed sheets or anything. And over here we have our two desks. So this is her desk and this is my desk. And at this desk, we don't really study. We don't really study in this room. And Case and I, we do our makeup here all the time. We have these lovely Impression vanity mirrors that we got our junior year and we brought it in, and it's amazing. It has three different levels of lighting, so it's great when we do our makeup. You have a cool, you have a warm, and then you have like a neutral in between. The bed's over there, and sometimes Case and I, we like to watch movies together, and so we project whatever movie we're watching. Maybe it's a TV show, maybe it's a drama, maybe it's an anime, and we watch it against this big white backdrop, and it's amazing. We never had a projector before, but Case actually got one in the summer, and since then it's completely changed the game. And I don't like using a TV as much. We only use a TV if we're out there sitting in the living room with, you know, other people. But if you can use a projector, I highly recommend it. There are some really inexpensive options on Amazon, which I'll link down below for the one that I use. It's the cheapest option, I think, and it's really great, and it just completely transforms the watching experience. It's like you're in Dolby Atmos, it's like you're in AMC theater again, but you're in the comfort of your own bed and you can snack in bed. It's the best thing ever. Okay, so let's move on to the next bedroom, which is Annie's room. So Annie is the only one in our household who has a single. She's not here all the time, so it makes perfect sense for her to just kind of have a single for herself. And so when we enter into her room is actually a lot colder than ours for whatever reason. And so, not to get too much into detail with her things, because this is her stuff, she has a clothing rack here, which she kind of puts whatever clothes she has. She has her twin bed, and then we also have our matching nightstand, desk, and chair. So all three of us, we do still have like the same furniture, which I think is nice because it just makes everything more cohesive. And we live in really far distance from campus, actually. It's around a 45-minute walk to the edge of campus, but we did this because this place is actually cheaper, and because of the pandemic, we knew that school was gonna be online anyway, so we didn't have to live anywhere really close to campus. And because it's further away, we were able to get a nicer space for a little bit of a lower cost. So to us, it felt like it was worth it, especially because we're seniors now. And that is all that I have for you guys for today's apartment tour. I really hope you guys enjoyed it and you guys have followed me along through most of my college journey, which is really exciting. Or if you guys are new, welcome to my channel. Make sure you guys follow my Instagram because I'm always posting on stories there. And I think I have a very exciting life, so you should definitely check it out. And I will also put my other roommates' information in the links down below so you guys can check them out and follow them. Case actually also has a Minecraft channel and a vlog channel, which you guys should subscribe to if you're into that kind of stuff. And everything will be linked down below. Thank you guys so much for watching this apartment tour. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think of my apartment. And that will be all for today's video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye! I don't wanna let you down. It's the only thing I think about every morning. You know my life ain't figured out, but I promise if you stick around it'll never